Welcome to the Hour of Harvest. It is great to have you with us as we worship the Lord. Sit back and enjoy as we share the good news of the gospel. We invite you to participate along with us as we sing songs of praise, read the Bible, and pray for those in need. The Hour of Harvest prayer team is standing by to take your prayer requests, praise reports, and lead souls to the Lord. You may call us at 606-464-4250 at any time during this program. May this program be a place where you feel accepted, loved, forgiven, and encouraged in the Lord. Hour of Harvest is touching countless souls with the unconditional love of Christ from the Appalachian Mountains to the Bluegrass region, across the nation, and around the world. From our studios in Beattyville, Kentucky, here is your host of the Hour of Harvest, Margaret Drake.
Good evening and welcome to our service tonight. We hope you will stay tuned. We have a good group to play and sing for you, and there's phone operators upstairs, so we have staff to operate the equipment, so we are all here to do our part, and that is to just lift up the name of the Lord is what we want to do. We welcome each of you. We are so glad to hear from you when we do. And this scripture tonight is a special comfort to all of us. And in the 14th chapter of John, Jesus was talking, and he was trying to bring comfort to the disciples and to all of us, saying, telling us that he's the only way, the truth, and the life. And so we're going to skip over to the 15th verse, and it's still talking about relationship to God and to Jesus. All right, starting with the 15th verse. Jesus said, "If you love me, you will keep my commandments. And I will pray the Father, and he shall give you another comforter, that he may abide with you forever, even the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it seeth him not, neither knoweth him. But ye know him, for he dwelleth with you and shall be in you. I will not leave you comfortless. I will come to you yet a little while, and the world seeth me no more. But ye see me, because I live, ye shall live also. At that day you shall know that I am in the Father, and ye in me, and I in you. He that hath my commandments and keepeth them, he it is that loveth me, and he that loveth me shall be loved of my Father. And I will love him, and he will manifest myself to him." And Judas said unto him, not Iscariot, "Lord, how is it that thou shalt manifest thyself unto us and not unto the world?" Jesus answered and said, "Unto him, if a man love me, he will keep my words, and my Father will love him, and we will come into him and make our abode with him. He that loveth me not, keepeth not my sayings, and the word which ye hear is not mine, but the Father's which sent me. These things have I spoken unto you, being yet present with you. But the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things and bring all things to your remembrance, whatsoever I have said unto you." And here's the key verse to this. Jesus said, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give unto you. Not as the world giveth, give I unto you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid." He's telling us, teaching us about the Holy Spirit, the Comforter that he sends and that is always with us. The Holy Spirit is with us if we have accepted him as our personal Savior, then he comes to stay with us. And so we have so much to be thankful for tonight. And it said, Jesus keeps saying, if you love me, you'll keep my commandments, or you'll do what I say. You know, sometimes when you've got little kids and you think, well, I wish they loved me like that I love them, because they sometimes don't listen to you. But that's kind of the way it was here with the disciples. They wasn't hearing what Jesus was saying. He said, now, if you love me, you will keep my sayings. You will do what I'm saying. But that we're not to worry nor be upset, because Jesus is leaving us his peace. And you know, there's times in each of our lives when we have to have his peace, because no one else can do it for us. We can't do it ourselves. But when he comes with peace, then we can make it. So it's so important to know what the word says about how the provisions that he's made for us. So if you need prayer tonight, the group will be glad to pray for you if you want to call. Let's pray right now. Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you for the Holy Spirit. We thank you for your peace, Lord Jesus, that you give to us, and it stays with us. And so those tonight that are troubled and distraught and going through hard times, we just ask for a special blessing on them. Bless our singers and our staff, our phone operators. And we're all here for one reason, Lord, and that is to lift up your name. You know that. And so we just ask that that happen in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, tonight we're happy to have, let's see, maybe I better acknowledge this one gift in here first. It's from the Onward and Upward group that's going to sing for us, and it's in memory of Dawn, and then also Sister Peggy Thompson and Brother Clifford Castell and Darlene Mantle and Earl Potter, and that comes from Peggy Carpenter. So we thank you in the amount of $50 to help the minister. We appreciate that, and we do appreciate those that try to help us keep going. All right, everyone has their instruments and ready to sing. We have Onward and Upward from McKee, Kentucky, and the phone number is 606-965-3287, and you'll be talking to Henry Carpenter, and he looks like he's got some visitors with him tonight. He can tell you about them if he wants to, but right now let's listen to some good music.
Sister Margaret, we're glad to be up here tonight. We're glad to see you back up here. You know, I watch you every night, and when you don't show up, I say, well, she ain't there again tonight. But it's wonderful to be back working for the Lord. And like Sister Margaret said, we want to dedicate this this program to Sister Peggy Thompson, that sung with us for quite some time, stood right here beside of me, and Sister Darlene Mateel buried her brother today up in Indiana's reason. She's not here with us. And, you know, these are people that we love from the bottom of our heart. They're good Christian people. So we just like to do this program and send it out to their families. And just good to be in the house of God. We'll go in toward the sunset of time, traveling the highway home. This world of sin I'm leaving behind. I'm traveling the highway home. Traveling the highway home. I'm traveling the highway home. So narrow. Traveling the highway
marker for me to travel the highway home. They're all in the Bible, plain as can be. I'm traveling the highway home. Traveling the highway home. I'm traveling the highway home. So narrow the way, thank God I can say. I'm traveling the highway home. Sometimes the road seems weary. But in my heart there's always a song. I'm traveling the highway home. Traveling the highway home. I'm traveling the highway home. So narrow the way, thank God I can say. I'm traveling the highway home. So
now I'd never live in a mansion, but I will someday. And I've never sung with an angel, but I will someday.
Amen. Addition to the group, we're gonna let him get us going to do a couple of songs, and we should have been a little short-handed. You know, the Lord always supplies our needs, so we ain't short-handed. we've got all we need. Brother Steve Isaacs.
Send these songs out to my family and all my church family watching.
Once I coming.
I'm ready.
A long time ago, and Lord, what a feeling it was. I told my wife I'd wave at her. Hi, honey. And my sister down in Tennessee, I know they're watching tonight. And Brother Virtual Lakes, I run into him down at Walmart. He's going to be watching, wanted to wanted us to sing a song for him. But, you know, it's just a wonderful thing to be able to praise the Lord. It's a wonderful thing to be able to stand on that rock and know that salvation is ours. It's not something we have to go out and buy or nothing. It's ours. Jesus Christ hung on the cross of Calvary and paid that debt. It's an old song that I learned a while back. Well, today I took a trip back home again, and I walked the same old road I walked back then. I remember all the good times that used to be. Yes, I took a trip back home in memory. I see my mama working in the garden, and all the flowers she planted each spring. I see my daddy in the fields of flowers. Yes, I do. Back home in memory. There we go. Amen. I walked by the church on that same day. Saw the altar where I used to kneel. I remember when God's Spirit set me free. Yes, I took a trip back home in memory. I see my mama working in the garden, and all the flowers she would plant each spring. I'd see my daddy in the fields of flowers. Yes, I took a trip back home in memory. Yes, I took a trip back. Amen.
I want to send this song out to, I don't know their names, I've forgot them, but it was someone I ran into at Walmart. And I told her I would send them a song out. And their last name is Durham. I do know that. So this is for you. From strength to strength, we sometimes go. Then again, we're sinking low in the shadow. Mountain luring high above our head, we need not fear what lies ahead. For His word, He's often said that our faith would be sufficient to make the mountain disappear. Speak to the triumph over me. Be thou removed from here to yonder, disappear into the sea. Speak to the mountain, speak with authority.
the midst of the battle, when the foe is moving ground, just look up and see the mighty hand of God reaching down. Speak God's name and Satan trembles. Speak His word and watch Him flee. And once again, my God delivers. The mountain crumbles at His feet. Speak to the mountain. You will not triumph over me. Be thou removed.
This is a song that my newly acquired daughter-in-law said she loved it awful good. And I wasn't really planning on doing it, but it's got a good message to it. If I'm only a pilgrim and a stranger, and it's unfriendly world that I roam. Jesus, who brought me from darkness, has promised me a heavenly home. In the Bible we read of a city whose builder and maker is God. And someday when this life is over, its beautiful sight will be home. I'm longing for home.
I'm longing for home.
The sun goeth down.
The sun goeth down.
I want to go where. Sweet rest can be found.
Sweet rest can be found.
I'm just about through. This old house of clay.
This old house of clay.
I'm leaving this world.
I'm leaving this world.
For glory someday.
For glory someday.
When the last weary mile has been traveled, and the gates of that city went wide. Oh, what a glad feeling will be to know that heaven is mine. Beyond the dark veil of sorrow, with Jesus forever I'll be. Oh, to that city I'm going, behold the Savior to see. I'm longing for home. The sun goeth down.
The sun goeth down.
I want to go where. I'm just about through.
I'm just about through.
With this old house of clay.
This old house of clay.
Down. Down here, the burden's heavy, and the road is rough and long. Sometimes my feet grow weary and so slow. There's a brighter day a-coming. Soon I'll step on heaven's shore, and I won't have to worry anymore. No, I won't have to worry when I reach the other shore. All my troubles will be over, and I'll rest forever. My eyes will be on Jesus, and my heart will be aglow, and I won't have to worry anymore. Play it, Lonnie. Someday when life is over and I've said my last goodbye, I'll see my Savior standing at the door. I'll hear Him say, "You're welcome, all you care. And I won't have to worry anymore. Oh, I won't have to worry when I reach the other shore. All my troubles will be over, and I'll
I've sung it here quite a bit, but I never did tell the story behind it. But when my husband passed away, the Lord, He just ministers me to me through my singing. And I pulled this up on YouTube, and I have been singing it ever since. And it just, for some reason, it just gives me comfort.
Into the windows of heaven, I can close my eyes and see where there are no earthly struggles, and the soul there is set free.
Amen.
Where the deaf and dumb are shouting, where the blind can finally see, crippled legs are dancing all across that crystal sea. Now there's a special place in heaven where those unborn babies play.
and they're rocked in arms by mama.
Amazing Grace.
Somewhere beyond the grave, there is a land that Jesus went to prepare. Grace.
let me dream on. Call it heaven, but I call it home.
Someone said you can't go back home again. Things will never be as good as they were then. But I've got good news. Amen. For you. When heaven
Thank you, Onward and Upward, and some of their guests tonight. But if you want to get in touch with Henry Carpenter, call him at 606-965-3287, and he'll tell you where they're going to be singing and so forth again. So we have some calls in. Her son Thomas and her brother Dana has called for them from Letcher County. Said they got a good report from the doctor, and so that's happy. They're happy about that. Here's some folk enjoying the program tonight. Clifford from Lee County and needs prayer for Milford. Silas said the singers are really great tonight. David. From Garrett County, wanted prayer for himself. He's dealing with grief, and also he wanted to hear the song, I Want Us to Be Together in Heaven. Christina from Pike County, pray for her brother. Diane has called from Bath County and says that WLJC is her church, and she loves us. Thank you, Diane. Melissa and Jerry from Whitley County has called. And Brenda from Morgan County. And we have a brother-in-law that has cancer. Tammy has called for him. A girlfriend from Menifee County needing some help. Alina from Leslie County. She wants a prayer for her husband. He's very sick and has a lot of health issues. We want to pray for them. They love the Lord. Sharon from Floyd County, physical needs and in a lot of pain tonight. And we have a gift called in of the amount of $100 for the ministry. And and this person says, just because the Lord has been so good to them, is they wanted to give $100 to the ministry and help keep the gospel going. Thank you so much. Mary from London, she's sending in $40 to the ministry, and this is in memory of Don Lovins, and in honor of me. Thank you, Mary. Appreciate that. Appreciate all the cards and letters and so forth that I keep getting. I just can't talk too much about it, but the Lord knows. The Lord knows what we need and how to help us. And so, here's from London. Someone's family needs salvation. Barbara from Madison County, traveling to the doctor. Ava and Bubba from Madison County. All right, Virginia from Montgomery County, Wilma from Lee, Rebecca for her children from Montgomery County, and we have some just now came in, and let's see. Oh, these clips get a little contrary here. Linda from Laurel County, Hurley and Joanne, Clifford has called for them. All right, Shirley from Montgomery County, Joyce from Johnson County. A friend has called for Shade, and Thelma from Madison County for her family. She's got a large family, and I appreciate how that she always prays for her family. And so that's what we need to do right now. We're about to run short on time, but let's pray. Join with me, please. Father, in the name of Jesus, we bring these to you. You already know about them, but you have instructed us to bring our cares to you. And so we bring all of these people. They're hurting, some emotionally, some physically, some spiritually. And so, Lord, we ask that their needs be met according to what it is that they're standing in need of. Bless each person. Encourage their hearts, Lord, to help them know that life is going to be really short, and we're soon going to be facing you. And help us to all be able to look forward to that with joy. Bless each person that has been with us. And in Jesus' name, amen. All right. We appreciate all of you that called and those that are standing behind the ministry. And so we have... We want to again thank the folk for being here from Onward and Upward. And if you notice, one of the ladies that was singing it is no longer with us. They've gone on to be meet the Lord. So, well, we are about out of time. We ask you to pray for the ministry and all of the needs that we have to keep the place going. And the Lord knows about that, too, but we need to ask Him. So from all of us, we want to say good night, and God bless you.
Thank you for being part of the Hour of Harvest. We hope that you are truly blessed and encouraged every time you watch. This program is made possible by your contribution and support. Would you become a financial partner of the Hour of Harvest with a one-time or monthly offering? You can send your pledges of support to the Hour of Harvest, Post Office Box Y, Beattyville, Kentucky, 41311, or visit us online at www.hourofharvest.com. We also accept Venmo and PayPal. Just scan the QR codes to donate. May God bless you.